be really exciting for me, as I'm going to introduce you to my brand new small business. And it's called Element Candles. So, as you might work out from the name, I have started up a candle business. Yay! And the reason I've done this is because I wanted something else to fill my time in lockdown. And so I thought, what do I absolutely love more than most things in the world? Kind of went out on a whim, bought all the equipment that I need for it, and all the wax, tons of fragrance oils, and I pretty much just got to work experimenting and making candles. So it's very exciting. Now I don't know if you know this about me, I don't know if I mentioned it in my Q&A, I might not have done, but I have a degree in visual communication. So that covers things like graphic design, illustration, so on and so forth. So I decided this would be a really good opportunity for me to bring those skills in and to start designing the packaging, the branding, and absolutely everything to do with the candles. And I was right. I've found a new love in my life. So what I'm going to do today is basically talk you through each of the candles I have made that are ready in my shop to be sold. I will put the link down below in the hopes that you might go and check it out. And yes, there is also a code for you to use as well to celebrate Mother's Day, which is coming up soon. So if you are interested in that, then give me a follow and I may disclose it to you. I say follow, but subscribe. So without further ado, I will go through each of the candles so you can get a sense for what their scent entails, and see whether you like it or not. So, oh, I also say as well, the candles are made out of 100% soy wax, so it is au naturel, and I hand pour them all, so they are very homemade. Yeah, there's not too much to say on the matter. So the first one. This one. I've realised it might be backwards to the camera. And it's the rose and jasmine. So as you can see, that is my logo on the top there. You can see in the reflection. I've just put finger marks on it as well, but this is not one that goes out to customers. This is purely for me to keep track of them all. So it just says Element Candles. And I've called it Element Candles because of the four elements. And because it is a fire. This is the element, the symbol for fire, sorry. Out of all of the elements. So that so they are all made with this lovely black matte glass container. This is 30 cl, and copper top lid, which I think looks really nice. I then add in my logo stickers on the top, and each candle comes with its own label for the scent and a colour to match as well. So I've gone for this light pink for this one, for rose. It smells absolutely amazing. I realised my nose was a bit blocked when I did that. So I've just added a little insight onto the website as well. And I've just put bring the garden inside with this magical floral blend of lemon, rose, honeysuckle, jasmine, sandalwood and cedarwood. So there's a lot that goes into that one. I feel like it reminds me of soap in like maybe my granny's house when I was growing up. Just another thing about my candles is I make them with 10% fragrance, whereas most retailers make them with around 3%, which means mine are incredibly strong scented. So that is the first. I love the colour of that as well. I'll just go on to the next one, which is the Tabac and Bois. I've named these in French, and there isn't really any significance other than I love the French language and I think it's beautiful. And I just think it sounded classier than the names in English. And I'm not French at all. I just thought it sounded nice. So this is the Tabac and Bois. And that stands for literally tobacco and wood. It's a nice sort of smoky brown label. And again, it's topped with my logo there as well. These lids are collecting a little bit of dust because these are the ones that say sat on my shelf. Don't know why I'm putting it down. So I've added a little description on the website. It says a smoky, woody blend of black oud, patchouli, amber, tobacco, oak, and leather. Incredibly warming scent. This one is perfect if you enjoy woody scents. The last one, I'd say, is more for floral or clean. So, those are the first two. We've then got vanilla and tobacco. And I've chosen this really nice creamy white for the label, which I just think looks so nice with the copper and the black. So I'm happy with that. So the description is, So this is Poivre Noir et Bois, which is translated literally to black pepper and wood. Sounds, I don't know if I'd be attracted to that if I saw it, but then I made it, and as I was making it, I thought, oh, that smells amazing. So, and I actually love the colour of the label as well. It's like a browny grey. So, this one actually really reminds me of men's aftershave. And I really like that smell for some reason. So, I love it. And the description is, add a touch of warming spice to the home with this blend of black pepper, oud wood, black oud, vetiver, I never know how to say that, cedar wood, and patchouli. Say to you, this has gone down such a treat over Mother's Day. Well, it's not Mother's Day yet, but in preparation for Mother's Day, I've had a lot of people order this one, so I think it must be appealing to mothers. So Pêche is peach, and of course jasmine, and I have chosen this nice peachy colour for it as well. So the description is as follows. Scent is simple yet incredibly effective and keeps the house smelling floral and fresh. Do apologize. This is another one of my favourites. This is Pamplemousse et Mandarine. Oh, I just love it. Look at the colour of that. You can just tell it's... Oh, sorry, the last one was fruity. I'm going to keep forgetting that. You can just tell this one's nice and vibrant and given it this very apt minty green label because it stands for mint and lavender. So this is really, it's really nice and minty. So the description of this candle is as follows: an intoxicating herby blend of peppermint, lavender, cinnamon, patchouli. Herby scented candle, I'd say. I did. One of my friends actually said she'd really like a minty scent in the kitchen. So, if you want any tips, I would recommend that. It's quite nice as well, I think. Hearing cinnamon and peppermint in a candle doesn't sound that great, but actually I think the cinnamon's not very strong. It really brings out the peppermint, so it works. So the next one is probably another one of my favourites. I know I say that about most of them, but this is Lavande et Pois, so it's lavender and pear, with this nice, oh I love that colour, like a pale violet, like pastely purple. So this is really, well I'll read the description. Walking through a typical English countryside or like a nice English garden with the pear. I just love the smell of pear. So that's really nice. Love that. Next scent, it's Grenade et Ombre. I think quite a lot of people have asked for a scent like this, because it's made with pomegranate, which is really popular. So I've made a sort of dusty pink label for it, which again I think is really nice with the copper. So the description is a dark and fruity blend of pomegranate, amber, white musk, honey, on to another fairly popular scent. Quite a few people have liked the sound of this as well. And it's Framboise et Rose. So Framboise is raspberry, which I really like. So it's more of a sweet pink colour. So the description is a thrilling the raspberry in it actually almost reminds me of drumstick lollies, if you've had them, like an old school sweet, retro sweet. Yeah, so nice. So I'd say that's very sweet but floral. The next one is really interesting actually. This is Citron et Patchouli. And as you may have gathered from the label, it's very citrusy. So this says an exhilarating citrus blend. And that is, citronella is really good for warning off mosquitoes, so it invites guests to your home, but it also wards off uninvited guests from your home. If you've not smelt citronella before, it's kind of, it's really strong, but it's like, I think the candle overall, it's like a creamy citrus, it's really nice. Gentle but strong at the same time. So it's really nice. I love it. And then I think we're on our final scent. Which is another citrusy one. Bergamot et Lavande. Also, sorry if I'm pronouncing everything wrong. As I said, I'm not French. I took it at school, but I've not done half of these words before, so. The description is a scintillating citrus blend. Not hinting there. It's just an idea. But yeah, this is, so it is citrusy, but it has a slight touch of floral as well with, well, it's got a few flowers in there, lavender, ylang ylang, and patchouli. But the bergamot is probably the most predominant note in there. So, really stunning. But yes, that is my full range of candles. So, as I said, they come in 30cl containers. As you can see, they're quite big. I will also be releasing some miniatures soon. I can't give an exact date, but for an example, they come in this size. It's a really sweet little tins. I suppose that'll be ideal if you're looking to just kind of try before you buy the bigger version. But I will hope to sell them in packs so you can try a mixture of scents there as well. So for example, like the citrus ones together, the floral ones together.